In all seriousness, since we're looking at approving the agenda, Jamie, is Archie. In Jamie's absence, is there anything that we really do need to postpone? Are you prepared to go through the majority of this stuff?
Yeah, she told me.
Okay. So I don't want to put you in an unfair spot and I mean speaking about or trying to speak on something that you may not be educated on, so that's fine. Okay. Do you want to move to approve the agenda?
I move to approve the agenda.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? All right, agenda's approved. Any questions or concerns on the consent items?
Do you have information about the budget and the numbers in here? That's just what she gave me here.
Okay. Did we ever ask why there was such a difference in subscriptions? I can't remember. Is there, we talked about that before.
One of these line items she called out last month, and I can't remember which one it was. I don't remember, Lisa.
Okay. I mean, it's all, ultimately, it's all okay within the budget.
Right.
So.
I do remember her last month calling out one of the line items to explain why it was off from what it should have been.
Okay.
Could have been that one, but it also could have been, don't we have another one, repairs or something?
Yeah, that one was the one that.
That was the one. Maybe that was the one she talked about.
That they.
I honestly don't remember.
Added back, amended the budget.
Okay.
Do you know, Pam, of any subscription expenses that would have been unexpected or different, other than what? And if you don't, that's fine.
Got it right.
Okay.
And that's fine. That's fine. Like I said, the budget still worked fine, so it's not as bottom money.
We'll table that till. If we want to ask, we can ask.
I'll just look at it next time.
Yeah, she's ready to answer, I suppose. Any other questions, comments, concerns on the board minutes or the March work schedule? Anything that you wanted to add to that, Pam, to your knowledge of any of those consent items?
Move to approve the consent agenda.
I'll second the motion.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Any consent items approved? Communication from the public. I don't see anybody here, so Pam slash Jamie, you're up.
Thank you. Okay. Library statistics. See the monthly stats in your packet. Reports, all numbers are up. And what's new for library circulation is up considerably. April circulation was within 100 books of March, and that was without spring break crowds that we had in March. We're continuing to separate easy nonfiction by subject to make it easier for the kids to locate.
Nice.
And we're getting more cubes. Cube shelving has arrived, but it's not assembled yet, so that'll be out on the floor soon. Although line items continue to show high, we are still on track budget-wise. We're hoping to come up with some storage solutions for the back office and storage rooms soon. Outside windows are scheduled to be cleaned sometime this month. We had to have 5 toilets repaired in April with a cost of approximately $600. Handicapped accessible door needs repaired and the technician has been called.
Just out of curiosity, was there like a recollection of the toilets or why somebody?
They were leaking.
Okay.
And one was even rocking.
Okay.
And
they just lit their life.
Yeah.
Okay.
The guts were not working.
Never a good feeling.
And our muralist Doug Applegate will be doing, working on the mural May 10th and 11th out here in the kids' area.
Cool.
Inventory is completed. Yay! We were happy with the data collected and are working on cataloging improvements to make next year's inventory run smoother. And the monitors are installed in the library thanks to the Friends, and the library programs are now easily visible. After visiting with Gary and Lindsay, it was determined that we can continue to operate as we have in the past as far as donating weeded materials to the Friends of the library. No need to change that. We do have a donation box out here now.
But last time we talked about maintenance, like we had to put some language or something.
She had something in the packet that said that the response to that was.
That's right.
Okay. Was that we could just call them on cell phone.
Right.
Or
got it.
Got it.
And then number 11 in the report, we do not have to designate a purpose for the trust unless the donor specifies a use. It just has to be used for the benefit of the public. And there was no budget amendment for us this month. Donations are considered into the actual budget. This will change next year with donations going into a trust. However, the trust is still taken into account when budgeting, and that money is expected to be used.
In that fiscal year? I assume that's what she means.
Yes,
that's,
yeah.
Okay. I thought it said that it could roll.
That's what I thought too, when we, from the slides that we looked at last time.
Just have that. Is that document?
I didn't bring my last one to happen either.
Everybody was in this.
And it's my favorite thing too.
Definitely, it's nice.
Just get annoyed. I'm number 86.
I know, that's wonderful. Well, that's kind of what was my point.
I know, but Polk City's not as fast as mine, right? Writing list, right, yeah.
Well, what I was thinking though is if you had how many libraries are in that thing? And the most popular books you think every library would buy, you'd almost have like 87 copies out there, but it only seems like there's only four or five at most. I was just curious how it worked.
So what do you want me to read?
Well, we need to pass the resolution.
Why don't you wait for that?
Oh, so we're gonna, yeah.
I think that's what we're gonna do.
She's just gonna give us that for an hour.
Yeah.
So when you get
to
the...
Oh, yeah. Okay. Keep it up.
Yeah.
All volunteers, including youth, must undergo a background check and be fingerprinted at the police station. 90-plus people attended our Pete the Cat story time on April 14th. After this, we have invested in a large Bluetooth speaker and microphone system that will allow audiences to hear better when crowds are large. And this will also benefit any programming that we have at the library. SHIP and Social Security classes were offered in April and well attended. The Adventure Pass program has launched and several patrons have already written on reserve their passes. Director Nowak has started the Public Library Management 2 class, which will run through the end of the month. Focuses on strategic planning and meeting community needs. This will be beneficial as we begin looking at our 5-year plan this fall. Director Nowak attended the State Director Roundtable on May 1st with an emphasis on human resources. History of the Book traveling exhibit from the State Library of Iowa is here in the main library until May 10th. Make sure to check that out. And we had 15 applicants for the temporary summer position. We blacked out identifying information, and each full-time staff determined their favorites. 3 people were interviewed. Trinity Beckham has accepted the position pending board approval. Almost done. We were almost ready for the summer reading program. Lots of fun things at the library this summer. Libraries Rock is a theme. Monday movies, Tuesday story time, Wednesday school age programming, Thursday performers, 2 teen programs scheduled, and adult programming, the CCC in Iowa by Linda McCann, Euchre Afternoons, Kindness Rocks, it's gonna be our rock painting, Rock the Croc cooking, and stamping cards. And we are working on the parade entry for the Four Seasons Festival. It would be great if some of the board members could walk with us and hand out whatever we decide on. Upcoming programs, May 10th is DIY paper art butterflies. May 12th, Daddy and Daughter Hair Program. May 17th, 50 Shades of Blue and Gray by Kathy Wilson, a historian. And this will be a great program if you want to attend that rather than hand out such reminders. And I also wanted to thank Daniel for setting up the equipment today.
Six watches.
And then I'll back page.
Are you at the board? I have no concerns about this, but have you heard anybody say anything that they're concerned about this event?
No, that isn't yet.
Interesting topic.
Yeah. She mentioned it a couple months ago, right? I raised my eyebrows.
Well, it sells. Okay. Anything else, Pam / Jamie?
I don't know, the board, did y'all get that too, the 1-4? The board would like the city to establish a special revenue fund. So
yeah,
that's that good. Later. Okay, that's good.
Okay. All right, again, I'm just so kind of keeping short and focus on stuff at the library. If you want to know more stuff, there's more stuff starting to go on now that, you know, we're a little bit settled into the year. But the main thing as far as impact of the library, I would say, is we are looking at engaging outside party to help the city with some forward-looking planning, with, again, part of our local option sales tax going away this year, the potential that more could go away in the future. We're growing, we have a lot of different needs, so we're going to put a request for, it's not technically a request for proposal, I think it's for information right now, but casting out our net to see if there are companies out there that can provide what we're looking for, again, just to kind of help us be strategic as we look forward, and then also look for potential other sources of, you know, revenue that we might be able to use, tap, so we don't have to keep increasing taxes. Obviously, we're going to do that this year, and don't want that to be the norm, so again, just some forward-looking help with any advice they can provide, but again, if they don't come back with somebody that, you know, gives us their qualifications and what they would do, and that's not really what we're looking for. We're not committing, and not sure what it would cost, so we would, that would be the next round. But so, you know, sometimes things like that, you can get more than what you pay for, so it's might be worth it, but again, it's still looking for information and evaluating what we get back.
So you like basically have some like strategic financial planning or
Yeah, I call it that, yeah. We've got the library potentially. That's me. If we do go down that route, I don't know what would come, and I'm sure there'll be conversations with department heads, or we'll see what develops, what we get, but yeah, that's well, again, I can, because our meetings are so long and because so much information is out there, I'll tell you about anything you want to know. I think what we're looking at hiring a new fire chief full time. That's a, you know, good day for the city, but I'm excited that you guys are all, there's a lot to accomplish in these meetings, so. But no, so our current, that's probably one of the other bigger things, is our current police chief, Dan Gubbins. He has a full time job, and that's a lot to be the full time police chief, or new fire chief here in Polk City as well. So we're looking and somebody
for that. Based off of what you did last week or last month, just so they know, the backfill that was at the Senate did not get taken away. So I mean, that definitely impacts our budget.
Yeah, not as much as like a local option sales tax thing, but it's always nice when they don't take money away from me that we currently have.
Anything else from Andy? Thank you. All right. Well, let's dive into our really short list of things to do. First item, review and approve revised circulation policy focusing on copy fees, suspension of privileges, and minimum age to get a car. Just the one that we looked at.
Yeah.
We looked at, and then we had a couple changes.
From last
time. I think last time we had, didn't we have two different ages? Like, it's kind of confusing.
Yes.
You had to be 14 to do something, and 15 to do something.
Yep.
Right.
She put in, yeah, she added the 14 underneath the parental.
Okay. And then didn't we add some language about discretional library advisor or library director? patron privileges could be revoked. And I think there was some discussion of, I don't remember what the copy fees were.
I think she lowered it.
She lowered it, yeah, because we were charging a quarter or something like that. It was only costing us a nickel or, I'm making those numbers up, I don't remember. But I remember it was, she said it was more than we needed to, so I think she was lowering it.
Representing copier is very efficient.
Yeah.
I think what she's, the new policy is she wants it to, the clause at it says allowing suspension of accounts for patrons who eventually require certified letters to get materials returned, and then the age to get a library card without parental permission is at 15 per the survey of the area library. So that is what she put into the policy.
Okay.
So that would be, if we are okay with it, we approve and or change.
And photocopies are down to 20 cents.
20 cents. Anybody have any comments or concerns on any of the things that
she talked to you all about this family? Is she happy with where, I mean, is this
here's
really?
Here's the one that got updated.
Yeah.
If anybody wants
so
to see
it. So this is really just.
It's just our edits, I think, and suggestions.
Okay. Yeah. She said it was pretty much approved. And
yeah, personally, I think that's why I wrote her.
And then she just rewrote it.
It was old business. That's why we couldn't approve it.
Oh, yeah.
And now since we now have that change, we can approve, review and approve.
Okay, so going back though, you said copy fees, what?
Those 20 cents here.
What are you looking at?
The one she sent today, or with the packet.
Okay, so where she said, in the email it says copy fees remain the same. We cannot have patrons print to a less expensive copier because they are on a separate network. Current printing is expensive. So that's in the body. Okay. So is that what you're saying? So that
this is an appendix.
Correct.
So we thought it was going to change. That says 20 cents, that says it's unchanged.
Right.
And then
right.
So it's We did change it.
So we didn't change it, we did change the suspension language in the minimum age.
Correct.
Is everyone okay with that?
Move to approve the revised circulation policy.
I'll second the motion.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, all right, the circulation policy.
Do you want to sign it as you go or all at once later?
Well, you're all. Okay, social media policy, I think this is similar to what we took, I think this is all the same as last time. This is also, we know business one, we read it and.
There was some question about the photo stuff.
Yep, and inappropriate content, and I do remember that. So I don't have any memory of any further.
Move to approve the revised library social media policy.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, none, all right, social media policy approved. Volunteer policy.
So what should we add to the background check?
Because that's required, and as you mentioned, we also have to do a, is that workers or volunteers, they have to do a fingerprint?
Everybody.
Interesting. All right.
Motion to approve the library volunteer policy.
Second.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed.
Hold on a second, so. I'm missing. The social media. Okay, you just said volunteer.
Yep.
Oh, and then.
Good, Lisa?
Yeah.
All right. Personnel policy. This one appears to be a new one.
I think they should just add it. That of the line regarding library employment of members and board of trustees, so no library board of trustees or their immediate family can be employed. That's what she added.
All right.
So, did we talk about this last week or last month?
I don't think so.
No, but I think it may have come up in regards to that part-time position that was.
Oh.
So we had talked about like the possibility of somebody's child being able to work in that position, and I guess as clarification was found that they could.
Okay.
Okay.
So that, do you want me to read what that whole policy is? Folks,
we have that one, right?
Yeah,
we have that one.
Oh, we have that one.
I think the first three were the ones we talked about.
The carry over.
From here on out, I believe.
Okay.
I'll move to approve it, but I just want to make sure there's another.
To me, this one's pretty short, so I like that we just say we use the personnel policy and then clarify who can. I've got nothing.
I move to approve that line edit.
I'll second the motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Personnel policy check. Discuss development of policy for digital sign and possibly consolidate the posting of announcement of flyers policy and display these policy.
So it looks like we have obviously the two, and I think she said it was from the city of Oline that she got this combination one.
So this one that says, that starts with displays and library postings policy is the combination of these other two.
Correct.
And that's based on a
other
libraries,
yes.
And she just changed it to City of Hope City, but then.
And Jamie also wants to discuss if Friends
can sell messages legally. There's legally no issue for City Hall. Friends that wanted to, like, sell.
Like, sell ad space or something?
Yeah, or like birthdays or whatever.
I would like to discuss that one further.
Yeah, I think I'd want to follow up with more information.
I don't know how, like, who would get the dollars for that. Does that go to Friends? Does that go to here?
That's kind of messy.
Yeah, I just don't understand how they donate it to us and then they can turn.
Yeah, let's table that.
So we should we look at the policy, right?
Yeah.
We can approve the policy.
Yeah, right, right.
Just discuss that.
So it looks like it's.
Because that's not on here, right?
No.
I didn't, I just read through it and see.
The one thing that I did notice that wasn't in this new policy.
That's ridiculous.
Well, and then the, yeah, the value is which we have added, but obviously I'm guessing it doesn't.
See, I wonder.
Yeah, well, I guess that's what I want clarification, like, so what happens if something happens and
it's back here, I think, on the back. They sign and they release the library from responsibility. Is that what you're going
to do? Yeah.
Okay. I thought that was fine.
Yeah, it still doesn't address it in the, it's, yeah, it still doesn't address it in the combined, but I think, yeah, it's just saying that you don't have insurance to cover it.
It makes them, yes, their job a lot easier to collect the certain insurance, which is kind of a pain. I mean, people can, like, get insurance and then get that certificate and then apply it or, you know, terminate it, so it really isn't as.
Well, for my insurance agent days, I believe the $2,500 limit is generally the amount that those types of collections are insured on your property, and if you move and you're supposed to buy what's called an inland marine, that would insure it anywhere. So I'm wondering if somewhere along the line somebody lost something here or got damaged and they didn't have any coverage at home and then came here and said. I also think we're covered by bullet point number 2 and 4 on the back side that say you're not covered, and number 4, you must sign a release that I would assume would also, I don't know what that release looks like, but I would assume it's
this.
Oh, very well. Yeah, it is. So that would basically say, yeah.
Yeah, that it restates it again.
Yeah, so I.
It is a locked case, but.
Yeah.
I think as long as they're signing it, we make sure
it's pretty clear here that we're not covering you if something happens to it. So, to me, I'm fine.
So that's where that. Number 2 just comes out because we're just not going to do it at all.
Right. We just tell them they aren't covered at all, and if you want to take that risk, there you go. For example.
I need to show that we display the library posting policy.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed. Okay. Item number 6, review tier standards, section 5, virtual spaces.
Technology and the internet continue to change the face of our public libraries. So I'm just going to go down through the tiers. Number 35, tier 1. This is an enhanced standard. The library offers public access internet, enabled devices, and staff training in their use. So this would be, devices are located in a public area, and we do have that. We have all the computers, which are now in the carol together there. 36, tier 1 is an enhanced standard. The library counts the total number of public use of internet-enabled devices in the library. If the device is used for multiple purposes, and internet use cannot be isolated, report off use. So we do take all typical, let's say, week or. Yeah, so that's just how we do it.
Now, say that again. Are you determining whether or not the, just that the computer is being used or that it's being used for the internet only.
The library counts the total number of public use of internet-enabled devices in the library. So the total number.
What about my iPad when I just connected to your network?
Yeah, we can make little chicken scratches.
But you wouldn't know that because I'm here.
That's true.
There are ways to do that, just because...
Oh, wait, down here, sorry.
Okay.
Do not count the use of wireless by customers with their own devices.
Ah,
so,
there we go.
No.
Good.
Only count use of library-owned public use, internet-enabled devices.
Okay.
And we do keep track of that. 37 Tier 1, which is new, the library provides a printer for public use. The printer may be a shared staff public device. So we do have a printer. 38 Tier 2, change tier. The library provides wireless internet access for its customers. 39 Tier 3, enhanced standard. The library maintains a current website. To meet this standard, the website must include, at a minimum, access to the library's online catalog, information about the library, and links to local, state, and national resources. A social media page on a site such as Facebook does not meet this standard, but we do meet it on our website. Number 40, the library budgets for computer replacement on a regular basis. I think you've established that. 41, the library sets aside a separate computer location for use by children and or young adults who have the op. 42, the library provides computer and or internet training for its customers, which we have. And we do, and they can make appointments too if they need to go in depth. 43 new, the library has access to broadband internet access. Broadband internet is defined by the FCC as 25 megabytes per second, download speed, and 3 Mbps upload. 44 is new, the library provides access to and promotes online database products. Database products are used to research on a wide variety of topics, including genealogy, finances, homework help, job seekers help, and many others. Examples include Gale, EBSCOhost, Learning Express, ProQuest. We have one of those right on our homepage. 45, which is new, the library provides access to and promotes a downloadable materials collection. Example include Bridges and downloadable audio and video, which we do provide. And 46 is new, the library provides access to digitalized local collections. To meet the standard, the library can either digitize the collection or can contract with another entity that has digitized the collection. So, and this, Jamie said, was any online resource, so we have access, they can do that. So we have met the standards.
Yay, cool.
All right. Good news. Now, might you have that language back to what we talked about earlier? If you're comfortable, you can move it. I assume we don't need any more discussion on the trust or the donation. I think we've covered that ground, yeah.
So, the question was, the board would like to establish a special trust fund for the Burt donation. That was, how would we create the account? And the answer was, the library board needs to pass a resolution requesting the city council to create a special fund for the library, the designation that the funds can only be used for the library and must always be used for public purpose. We do not have to put special restrictions on it. The funds will roll over from year to year, however, they must be accounted for as part of each fiscal year budget.
Okay. So I think right to the part that's the last word would be public purpose, or last word would be public purpose. I think that's what we need to move.
Let me read that second. Her second question was, what do you need from me regarding budget amendments from donations we have received? Which main meeting do you plan to do amendments? Donations should have been estimated and accounted for in this year's budget. Would you like to respond to that? How would you possibly be able to know that you're going to get a donation?
Right. The only thing would be just to look over the last 5 years, but still, you know, what's your average over, you know, an extended period of time? It's still a pretty
big shot in the dark.
Since we are not in danger of going negative on our bottom line, the city will not do a budget amendment for donations received. They are now part of the general fund. Even if there was to be an amendment, we would have to have had the board action at the April meeting directing the city to do so. It needs to be published 20 days prior to council acting on it. Amendments will be done at the May 14th meeting. All future donations of any size will go, into the newly created special fund. So for some more for that was a question probably for how we dealt with the things we already
talked
gotten.
Right.
Now what we need to do is just make sure that we get it set so that they have a place to go in the future.
Mm-hmm. Correct. That's what I mean.
Including hopefully the bird donation.
So do you want to move to approve that resolution? Read it from the library board needs to approve a resolution, we'll wait.
The library board requests that the city council create a special fund for the library with the designation that funds will be only used for the library and must always be used for public purposes. Does that get it?
I told you to wait a minute that you didn't hear me, so. Could you wait a minute and see how you are? Yeah.
Is that what you're reading?
Yes.
James?
Yes.
Okay.
So,
in favor.
We should probably have her read that.
Probably should.
Yes. Just so we know what we're voting on. No, not after you yelled at me.
I didn't yell at you.
Red board meetings are now getting hostile.
I move to create a special fund for the library within the designation that funds can only be used for library and must always be used for public purposes.
Well, I don't know if it was Mike, the council, the board.
Well, you have to move.
You made a motion.
Do we need to, the language specifically says that the board needs to pass a resolution.
Yes.
Is that the same thing?
Okay.
So I think Mike moved to propose a resolution to the city council, blah, 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 blah. Whoever's watching, they're really going to think I'm the one.
Me too, I was like.
Yep, I think you got it right on the money.
To create a special fund for the library with the designation that funds can only be used for the library and must always be used for public purpose.
Okay, it was moved and seconded. Everyone clear on what we're voting on? All right. All those in favor of that movement, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? Now, I don't quite know what language to use other than to say they're asking us to move to allocate. Do we need to specify their name or?
So can we say like?
Most recent.
I move that the most recent birth donation be added to the trust. Can we do that if the board or the city hasn't recognized the resolution already? I guess we do it and.
Yeah.
Because we don't have time to change that.
It's just an order.
Okay.
Yeah.
If they won't do it, then they'll wait until the next month.
Right, yeah. Well, because we meet every 2 weeks, so we would meet again before you guys would meet next. So,
okay.
Yeah, hopefully they can just want
to.
So, yeah.
So
you want to do it? You got it, Lisa. Go ahead.
I move to allocate the bird donation to the trust. I mean, I don't know what to call the trust.
What do we call it? Special fund, Crystal? I think we all know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
We all know what. So all. Well, you moved it. Anybody want to second that motion?
I'll second the motion.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed.
All right. And we need to. I wonder. After we've already approved all of this, did we need to say something about all future donations? Will
I think we'll have to do that at the time we get them.
Okay, so otherwise our basic donations, which we kind of guess at from year to year, is part of the budget.
Part of the budget.
And then if we get big things like this, we try and put them into a trust. Is that what?
That's the way I'm
everybody's
understanding.
That's my understanding.
But I think they look at the trust when they figure the budget.
It'll be in the budget.
Okay.
For 19, right?
But as far as some...
Which again, it is, you know, conceivable because, you know, the money's for the library, so that they would...
Right. Okay, next up. New computer. Microsoft Office software would replace computer, replacing Windows.
That she sent you the...
Yep.
Okay.
$900 for the computer and $55 for the software.
I was going to ask you if that was
reasonable. It's kind of funny because I just bought four of these, same model, but with more RAM for about $200 cheaper. So apparently Iowa State gets a much better deal.
Hey, you buy more computers.
He's probably
yes.
Their clients.
So yeah, I think that it's fine. I would always like to see more RAM and more, and have the solid state drive just for longevity purposes. But for what we use it for here, it's fine.
Motion to approve the purchase of the new desktop and the Microsoft Office software.
Second.
All in favor, say
aye.
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 Okay.
Do we need to move to make that the old patron computer go ahead and take care of it and move it out of have no value, or is she ready to do that now? Did she say anything?
It'll probably go into the Carol and whatever old piece. Whatever
I
old
we're
is
replacing
there.
The Carol machine. We're not.
Oh, is that?
Okay. It says approved purchase of new desktop computer. Replacing oldest paycheck computer.
Yeah.
So.
Oh.
Well, how about don't get rid of it until the next meeting, and we'll find
right,
out what
okay.
She wants to do with it.
Yeah.
As long as we don't.
I just thought if she knew that already, she
yeah,
wanted
yeah.
to get rid of it. We can just take care of that now.
So let's make sure we tell her. Just don't pull
yeah.
it off. And she probably can anyway.
I'm sure it's beyond salvage.
Yeah. Okay. Did we talk about? We were still in the process of interviewing all that stuff last time. For the temporary position.
They have their person.
Well, I understand that, but I mean, we didn't talk about this candidate in particular. I'm just curious if anybody knows her, or did you interview her yet?
No, Jamie did.
Jamie did. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Then you probably know. Very good.
She does come in here. Very nice young lady.
Okay.
Uses the.
Not that matters, I'm just curious.
This is still one of my areas of confusion about the board, maybe as longer term people. I feel like this is a director decision. Why?
So it's no different than the city. When the city hires somebody, the council has to approve it. So it's the same thing. So she hired them, essentially, has probably given them an offer of employment, and then we just have to approve it for the rubber stamp. Or why they work. But city council, I mean, they always have to approve it. County board of supervisors always have to approve the hire.
Yeah, it just seems.
I think we had to do the same.
Yeah, I think when you write the offer, it's subject to.
I suppose maybe if somebody had come in as a during the communication from the public and had raised concerns about this person,
right.
Then we
yes.
could have had the opportunity to say. But otherwise, since there were no concerns, you have found the person that you're happy with. I move to approve that person get hired.
I'll second the motion.
Be hired.
All right. All in favor, say
aye.
Aye. Opposed, none. Okay, now the fun stuff. Nominate officers for fiscal year 19 terms, and that election voting takes place next week, or next month, right? June, is that what we're doing?
You had said at the last meeting that you thought you were going to have some trouble.
Well, yeah, look, I'll be happy to do it. I don't mind it at all. I just.
All those in favor?
I just want to be clear, too, and just make sure it's possible that I have to be gone a little more than I have been in the past. That's all. And I may or may not get good notice of when I have to do that. So I just want to be fair. I don't mind doing it for another year, really, but I'm. If anybody else wants.
Do you want to, or do you not mind doing it?
I will not have any hurt feelings if someone nominates somebody
else. No, I'm not. Probably not going to step up.
I understand.
But I don't want you to feel like you have to do it.
I do not feel a lot of way that
okay.
I have to do
okay.
it. I don't dislike it. I just.
I would like to nominate Corey Hooter for president.
I should have been more forceful.
Yay, Corey.
I would assume that could be the end of the nominations for that position, y'all.
Yeah, all of us with like less than
a year yet.
Right. This will be it. I started in May of last year.
Okay.
Yeah.
Or April of last year.
Well.
Does that have to be seconded?
No, it's just nominations.
Okay.
I think when we do the elections, we have to second.
Oh, then okay.
If I remember right. All right.
And then the other one is
secretary. Yeah.
Again.
Yeah, but Lisa, you've been doing a great job, but I can only imagine that this is—it's not any fun. But if you are willing to keep doing it,
thank you. I thought I had it like way put together. Like I took her direct report, put it in there, it was all ready to go,
yeah.
And then I was like, ah.
She was even trying to offend her voter site.
Right.
Yeah, that was a good move.
Just to show there's no hard feelings.
Yeah. I should have made everybody mad the last 2 weeks. All right, so did you just nominate, or otherwise I will nominate Lisa Martin?
I just, yeah, go right ahead.
Okay. Lisa, you're nominated.
No. So it was Mike that did it, or was it Corey?
I just did.
All right.
You're welcome. any other nominations?
You guys were nice to Angie. She missed out. You should have written it all on her. Although she still knew, so I'd be a little nicer.
Yeah. All right, so elections next month. Final item, consider creating a personnel committee for suggestion of state library board personnel. This is what I had talked about a few times.
I was going to add this to the agenda. She had to put this on about getting her evaluation done, because we talked about it a couple months ago.
Yeah, because it's been 12 months now, right? May, I think, was her first
more
meeting.
Than, I think.
July,
June was technically her first meeting, but
she was around before this.
She was a city employee before
yes.
that. Yeah, I can't. Might have to look back on that.
Do we know how they're usually set up? Did you have one before?
We did.
How many and how was it?
It was two. If I remember right, it was Mike and
Tom. Yeah.
And when those two left, we never did it again. Just think back, we haven't had anybody else. So. Yeah, last time it was two. I think that was it.
Because it has to be under a quorum, right?
Correct.
Right.
Now, I can't remember, Sarah or Angie, don't one of you guys have experience with...
Can't lie.
Yeah. With personnel issues as well as obviously Lisa.
Does anybody want to be on it?
I was exactly what mine being on it.
Okay.
Right then.
Done. Yeah.
Okay, so somebody needs to make a motion to create a personnel committee, I would assume.
Yeah.
I'll make the motion to create a personnel committee.
I'll second that.
All right, all in favor creating a personnel committee per suggestion of the state library board? Say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Okay, now I don't know.
So we'll do the same
we'll
thing.
Do the same
nominate
thing.
For
yeah.
that position for next month.
We need to nominate now.
Well, I guess it's either you or me.
Yeah, I'll nominate both of them. That's why I'll nominate Sarah for the personnel committee, and we'll consider that at a June meeting. And I think the way that worked last, just before, was the director would just reach out to the personnel committee if there was an issue with an employee or whatever, and you guys, I think they would generally meet, discuss. If something had to be brought back to everybody, they would do it. If not, then they would just handle it.
Do we need to outline that that's a yearly position or a multi-year position?
Yeah, when we could do it however. It was just a standing committee
on
those others.
Let's do it as a yearly.
Okay.
So
right.
It makes sense to do that when the other nominations
come up. That way it won't be forgotten.
Right.
do we need to move again or just add a year, maybe add language to the personnel committee approval?
For fiscal year 19. How's that sound?
Oh, just as a year, it's a yearly.
It's a yearly.
Yearly appointment.
So it's a committee with yearly appointments.
So that should serve, sorry.
Yeah.
So while Lisa's finishing up, then everybody, anybody have a conflict they know for June?
I will not be.
You will not be. Okay.
I would like to register my votes.
You can call it, yes, but it's somewhere.
I will be on the way.
Yeah.
Or like, yeah, I figured that.
So we don't know. Lisa, you'll be here. Sarah, you're okay. I'm okay as far as I know.
But again, if voting is necessary, I would like to pre-cast my votes for the people who have been already nominated.
Well, since it's like the Vladimir Putin election, there are no authorization.
Do we need to talk about these other, this last item she said about the when agenda items need to be submitted, or is that for next? The last piece that she had on this document was another conversation. Gary suggested we create a policy directing when agenda items must be submitted and when the agenda must be posted. He wants it down to a time.
This is not on my
I'm sorry.
This in is the a, email that she
yeah, yeah, it was at the very
yeah,
end.
Yeah, I'm trust. Now. Why?
I'm not really sure. Okay, maybe we can just table that.
Yeah,
I
think I'm going to ask
her. Feedback on that.
Okay.
I don't even see where that's at. Or is it,
it was,
attachment or is it in the
it's an attachment to that trust account.
I guess it's just a formality. Again, we don't often have things that, you know, people bring to the attention of the library board that need to be on the agenda, and then we would say, oh, sorry, you missed our, you know, I mean, but if you have a cutoff time, then if anybody has anything, they know the expectation.
I guess we have a posting date. We do not have a cutoff for the
submission. And again, we don't have stuff that, you know, but I mean.
And then it was also he and Lindsay questioned why we have to approve the work schedules on the agenda, which is another one of those things that I've questioned.
I got it almost too. We can just remove it from the consent items. I mean, it's not.
Maybe she might need to check on that and see.
It's just not on my.
Yeah. Let's talk to her about this.
I'm so sorry. Right. Sorry, Jamie.
Anything else?
Wow, that was pretty good.
We're adjourned. 7:22.